Hello, Aries. Welcome to your February 21st through February 29th weekly reading. As I'm shuffling up the cards, I do want to give my quick disclaimer. As this is a general reading, it will not resonate with everyone out there, so please take what does, leave what does not. Check your moon, your rising, your Venus signs for messages that may be more pertaining to you at this time, or to get a comprehensive overview of all the messages coming in. That being said, please do not make any life-altering decisions or decisions of any kind based off of a general reading. One, because it's not good practice. Two, not all the energies or information may be available to you in a general reading. So if you're looking for something that is tailored to you, please do get a private reading, and the information for me for that is in the detail box down below. All right, that being said, let's go ahead and jump into your reading. So at the heart of the matter, we have the King of Pentacles. What is crossing at this time is the World. At the distant past, we have the Queen of Cups. In the recent past, we have the Page of Swords. In the crowning position, what you would like to see happen is the Ace of Wands. Future energy is the Wheel of Fortune. How you see yourself is the Six of Pentacles. Outside influences, we have the Queen of Swords. Hopes and fears, we have the Four of Cups. Future energy coming in, we have the Ace of Swords. Overall energy, we have the Hermit, Virgo energy showing up here. And at the bottom of the deck, we have the Moon. So what I am seeing off the bat is there is a cycle that is completing or a new beginning that is starting. In the distant past, we have the Queen of Cups, which is the water energy, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Although it does not have to be, this is a queen who is loving, kind, gentle, loyal, motherly energy, although not necessarily a mother, likes to mother hen is the word I'm looking for here. Her tribe wants to make sure they're all taken care of and happy and very good and very compassionate person. She can be moody at times and withdrawn and a bit manipulative when it comes to emotions, especially when she feels like her tribe is not being well taken care of. So you are, what I'm seeing is that you're wanting is a new opportunity, a passionate new beginning here. Looks like luck is coming in for you. You're trying to get balanced. The outside influences, we have the Queen of Swords, air energy, Aquarius, Gemini, Libra. But this is somebody who, you know, has a lot of experience, very knowledgeable, can have a conversation with anyone, any place, anytime, anywhere. And very much somebody who is very, very smart, well-read, and intelligent, can think outside the box and does not tolerate anything that doesn't serve their best interest. So they're very quick to cut out things that are not serving their purposes. And the hopes and fears with the Four of Cups, I'm seeing, you know, sadness, dejection, I'm just kind of being bored in a situation. And what's coming in is a truthful new beginning, some mental clarity, or a truthful conversation. With the Hermit here, with the Virgo energy, we do have the need to go within to find any solutions to any problems, or even to understand what is happening here to get some type of answer that may be needed. Please do not sign gender or make zodiacs absolute with these cards, as it does speak to just the energies and the traits, and we all have masculine and feminine energy within us. So when I say he, I could mean she could be he. Take it as it resonates for you. Cross watchers are welcome. Please feel free to swap the roles if need be. All right. So at this point in time, and clarify, get another layer here and take a deeper dive and see what's happening under the surface. Spirit team, why is the King of Pentacles and the World here for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus? Please show me clearly. Why is the King of Pentacles here with the World card, please? Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so what's clarifying it is the Ace of Cups, the Page of Swords, and the Fool. So what I'm getting here is that we could be dealing with an Earth sign, a Virgo, a Capricorn, or a Taurus, where they're, you know, want to start a new cycle, a brand new offer, a new beginning, and love, a I do feel like there is somebody keeping an eye on somebody here. The Page of Swords seeks truth, seeks knowledge, and wanting to, you know, have the full be this new beginning. So I feel like, you know, you or them are seeking out whether or not to come forward and start this new beginning, this brand new start in love. Let's take a look here at the Queen of Cups. Why is it here in the distant past for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, please? Why is the Queen of Cups here in the distant past? Why is the Queen of Cups here in the distant past? Please show me clearly. Thank you. What's clarifying, it is temperance. So what I'm seeing is there needed to be balance. A healing took place in the distant past, maybe regarding to a water sign for some of you. Or this could be, you know, again, your energy, Aries, where, you know, you need to bring yourself into balance and healing. Why is the Page of Swords here? Recent past, please. Why is the Page of Swords here? Nine of Cups. Is clarifying. So this is wish fulfillment. So I feel like you were keeping an eye on somebody. Yeah, Tower. Trying to get some truth, or them, you, about whether or not to come forward. And this gave some type of an epiphany where maybe you had equaled things out a little bit. Why is the Ace of Wands here in the crowning position? Why is the Ace of Wands here for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus? Please show me clearly. Why is the Ace of Wands here? Thank you. So somebody is manifesting a passionate new beginning, a new start, and I feel like this is your person. Could be you. But we do have the Wounded Warrior here and the Knight of Pentacles. So this is somebody who is manifesting this new beginning, but they're coming in very, very slowly with this grounded, solid offer. But it may be moving so slowly that you do not know that it's even coming at this point in time. So let's take a look at the Wheel of Fortune. Future energy coming in, affecting this matter. Why is the Wheel of Fortune here? Thank you. We have the High Priestess and the Eight of Swords. So I feel like there is some truth that needs to be revealed here, or secrets that are going to be revealed. Someone is feeling stuck in this cycle. Maybe there's some disillusions, but somebody wants to have a victory here. We do have the Queen of Swords behind that, indicating, you know, that this is this outside person. They, you know, might not be seeing things very clearly. I think that's part of what's coming out, but they do want to have a victory with you. Let's take a look at the Six of Pentacles. Why does Aries see themselves with the Six of Pentacles, please? Show me clearly. Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, please. Why is the Six of Pentacles here? Bottom of the deck, we have the Seven of Wands. So this is indicating that you're standing your ground. You have the Four of Swords, indicating you need to taking a time out, bringing yourself into balance, trying to heal, but wanting to have a conversation, wanting to communicate with someone. Why is the Queen of Swords here? Outside influence, please. Again, Seven of Cups, bottom of the deck. Because they're feeling very stressed out, yeah, about the cycle. They want to start a new cycle with you, or they want to end the old one. But they have a lot of disillusions, a lot of fantasy going on, but they're right. All right, see, let's look at the Four of Cups, please. Why is it here? Getting is the Nine of Wands. This is that Wounded Warrior energy. Someone's feeling wounded. We got the Page of Cups clarifying the Four of Cups. And what I feel like is this person, and I don't feel like this is your energy, Aries. I feel like this is their energy, but do feel free to swap it if it resonates better. they're not satisfied. They're very unhappy with where they're at. They're wanting only one cup. They're wanting your cup. So any other offer that's coming in, they're not interested in. They may want to come in with an apology to you, for some of you. But from overall, I feel like the only cup that they're interested in at this time is yours. Why is the Ace of Swords here and the future energy coming in to this for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus? Why is the Ace of Swords here? Yeah. What's clarifying it is the King of Wands and the Death card. So what I'm getting there, Aries, is they're wanting to, someone wants to have a truth conversation about an ending that happened with you here. They want to kind of explain themselves, explain what happened. They definitely want some clarity here. They want a new beginning. They're feeling very stressed out and unhappy, disappointed. They only want you. They want this new beginning. And I feel like, you know, a lot of this, I feel like this is a lot of their energy. But, you know, there you are. You're wanting to communicate with this person, but you're wanting to bring yourself into balance and healing first. And the only way you're going to know whether or not you can continue this with this person is if you go within and really examine the whole situation to feel at peace with it. Again, some of you may be dealing with a Virgo overall, but I just feel like most of you, this is really speaking to really just taking some time out for yourself at this time. But take that as it resonates. But that's what I have for you for this week. So if it, please let me know in the comment box down below. I do read all comments. And if time allows, I do comment back. Please do give a thumbs up to this video to help it circulate for others. And if you have not yet done so, please subscribe so that you can get these messages as they are released. Otherwise, I will see you next week when I release March monthly video for the collective. That being said, remember to live in light and love, not just today, but every day. Namaste. Bye for now.